An obvious inspirational figure for me was Sir David Attenborough. Watching his documentaries growing up was always wonderful and inspiring. Now I actually get to support scientists as they learn more about our oceans, and that's really fulfilling. Hi, my name's Stewart Fairbairn, and I'm an electronics engineer in the operations team at the National Oceanography Centre. I'm responsible for all the electronic components on our submarines and making sure that they're ready to go on expedition. So I studied electronics and electrical engineering at university. The entry requirements for that course at Edinburgh University, where I studied, range from 3 A's at A level to 1 A and 2 B's. They also wanted those to include specific subjects such as maths or a science or another technical subject. So this is only my second role in my career, so I'm fairly early on in the grand scheme of things. During university, I had a number of industrial placements, either in my summers or as part of my final year of the degree, a full 6 months. After graduating, I had a brief stint in a graduate role in Edinburgh with one of the companies I'd worked with before, but I soon spotted what I considered to be a dream job down here at the National Oceanography Centre in Southampton. Now that I'm here, the learning isn't over either. Every day is a new challenge, and there's a lot to learn, but it's definitely been worth it so far. So I work a fairly typical 37 hours a week, Monday to Friday. This is nominally 8:30 to 4:30, but the workplace is quite flexible in how you adjust your start and end times of the day, which is great for getting that work-life balance. However, part of my role is also ship-based, when we take our submarines out for scientific expeditions. Working on a ship will be quite a different schedule. It's 12 hours a day for 7 days of the week. I've got my first expedition coming up later this year, so I'll get to experience that soon, but it should be quite an adventure. My working environment is split between an open plan office and a hangar workshop area. The open plan is where we would normally complete all of our computer-based work. The hangar, on the other hand, is where we keep the submarine, so a lot of the work done there is much more hands-on. We work together as a team to maintain and upgrade the submarine as required. One of the main things I do at the moment is getting the submarine ready for the next expedition. This involves making sure that all of the electronics are working as intended, testing them and fitting them all together into the body of the sub. Another responsibility is tracking any changes and upgrades that I make so that future engineers have a clearer picture of what's going on. I also have to look at the longer term picture. As the submarine ages, some of the electronic components might become obsolete and go out of production. That can pose a risk to maintaining the machine if we don't keep the designs up to date, so keeping on top of that is important. Getting to travel is definitely a big perk of this job. It isn't every job that you get the chance to travel the world and work on research ships. Another perk is the general culture of trust in the office. We are given the freedom to assess problems and choose the solutions that we think will work best.